Hi, welcome to my channel. This is a continuation video of branch account. Okay, here we are going to see branch account and a stock and debtor system. Okay, I have already uploaded two separate videos for debtor system. In that, we have discussed about when goods are sent to branch at cost price. The another one is when goods are sent to branch at invoice price. Okay, the link is available in the description box. Now let us see what is stock and debtor system along with the problem. So before we see the problem, please subscribe this channel and hit the bell icon to get the further notification of my new uploads. Okay, now let us see the problem for stock and debtor system. See, first let us try to understand what is stock and debtor system along with the format. Then we can go for the problem. Okay, here we are going to see branch account and a stock and debtor system. See, in the previous video, we discussed about the same branch account under debtor system. So, according to debtor system, we'll have only one particular format. With that, we can find out the profit or loss at the branch. Okay. For the same purpose, even you can prepare branch account under this method, that is stock and debtor system. See, under this method, the head office will keep separate accounts relating to various types of transactions at the branch instead of one branch account. Okay, these are the important ledger need to be prepared in order to find out the branch profit or loss. Okay, let me explain each and every account separately. The first one, branch stock account. So here you have to record all the transactions related to stock. Okay, I'll explain each and every one along with the format. The next one is branch debtors account. So here you need to record all the transactions related to debtors. The next one is branch expenses account. So here you have to record only expenses which is related to a particular branch. Okay, to find out the total expense of branch. And the next one is branch adjustment account. So this particular account is required only when the goods are sent to branch at invoice price. Okay, generally the head office will send goods to branch in two different ways. One is at cost price or at invoice price. If the head office will send goods to branch at cost price, means in that case you need not prepare branch adjustment account. So branch adjustment account is required only when the head office will send goods to branch at invoice price. In that case only you need to prepare branch adjustment account. I'll explain along with the problem. And the next one is branch profit and loss account. So after preparing all the above accounts, finally you can prepare branch profit or loss account to find out the profit or loss at the branch. The next one is goods sent to branch account. So this account is required to find out the net value of goods which is sent to branch. Okay, the balancing figure will be purchase, total purchase, that will be transferred to profit or loss account or trading account according to the transaction. These are the various accounts which is required under stock and debtor system. Now let me explain each and everything along with the format. Look at the format. The first one is branch stock account. So branch stock account is required to find out surplus in stock or shortage in stock. In sometimes they will provide opening stock. In that case, the balancing figure will be either closing stock or shortage. Okay. If you find any balancing figure under debit side, it will be treated as surplus in stock. So here in branch stock account, you need to record certain things under debit side and certain transactions under credit side. The first one is you have to start with opening stock, if any. Okay, debit side you have to start with the opening stock, and any goods sent to branch during the year, that will be entered debit side. The next one is goods returned by debtors. Okay, so after selling goods to customer, that is debtors, if they find any defective in the particular product, they'll return the goods to branch. Okay, it is an inflow of goods. The first one, you have to start with opening stock and then enter any goods sent to branch, that is goods received from head office. This one is goods received from debtors, that is goods returned by debtors. Okay, and credit side, you have to record outflow of goods. The outflow of goods can be, these are the reason. The first one is cash sales. When you sell goods to outside, it can be cash sales or credit sales, whatever may be goods going out. Okay, so buy cash sales and buy credit sales, both will be entered credit side of branch stock account. So all these items of inflow of stock, all these items are outflow of stock. The first one is cash sales, next one credit sales, and any loss of goods due to some reason, if there is any loss, that will be entered in the credit side. And next one, goods returned to head office. Okay, this one is goods returned by debtors. It is an inflow for the branch, and this one is outflow because they are sending goods to, returning goods to head office. And finally, closing stock. And after entering all these things, you will be getting balancing figure either debit side or credit side. If you get any balancing figure under debit side, it will be treated as surplus. If we get any balancing figure under credit side, this will be treated as shortage. Okay. So sometimes if they provide all the other items without giving any closing stock, in that case, the balancing figure will be treated as closing stock. Okay. This is the format to prepare branch stock account to find out either surplus or shortage. Now let us see the second one. The next one is branch debtors account. See, this account is prepared to record all the transactions which is relating to branch debtors. Okay. In order to find out the closing balance of debtors or credit sales. Okay. So here you have to start with opening debtors, that is to balance brought down. This is the opening balance of debtors. Okay. And during the year, if there is any credit sales, that will be recorded debit side. So these are the two items need to be recorded under branch debtors account debit side. And now look at the credit side. The first one is any cash received from debtors, that will be recorded under credit side. And then any allowances to debtors, that will be entered under credit side. The next one is any discount allowed to debtors, that will be entered credit side. And if there is any bad debts means any irrecoverable amount from debtors, that will be entered credit side of debtors account. And the next one is returns. Okay, if there is any goods returned by debtors, that will be entered under credit side of debtors account. All these items need to be recorded under credit side of branch debtors account. Finally, the balancing figure will be closing balance, that is by balance carry down. So here you are going to find out either credit sales or closing debtors. So these are the two possibilities in order to prepare the branch debtors account. The next one is branch expense account. So this account is required in order to disclose, okay, in order to find out the total expense at the branch. Okay, the total expense will be transferred to branch profit and loss account. The expenses can be classified into two categories. The first one is these are the expenses which is relevant to debtors, that is bad debts, allowance, discount, etc. So these are the expenses related to debtors. So all these items you can take from the debtors account. So you have to mention branch debtors account. These are the expenses related to debtors at branch, so that you have to enter under branch expense account. That will be the first item. The next one is that is the branch expenses, for example advertisement, salaries, wages, rent and rates, etc. So these are the general expenses related to branch. So all these items need to be entered under debit side of branch expense account as to bank account. Okay, these are the two major expenses. The first one is branch debtors, okay, expenses related to debtors, and the next one is to bank, that is all the branch expenses. So these expenses paid by the head office. Okay, these are the major categories of branch expenses. Apart from the above, if there is any petty cash balance in the problem, okay, if you find any difference between opening petty cash balance and closing petty cash balance, the difference is called petty expense. For example, opening petty cash 300, closing petty cash 200. What is the difference? 100 rupees. That 100 rupees is called petty expense. That also will include in the branch expense account as to petty expense. Okay. These are the various categories of expense that comes under branch expense. The total expense will be transferred to branch profit and loss account debit side. The next one is branch adjustment account. See, this particular account is required only when the head office send goods to branch at invoice price. Invoice price means selling price. So selling price consists of cost plus profit. That profit you are added, no, that you have to show separately under branch adjustment account. So this account is required only when the head office send goods to branch at invoice price. Okay. I will explain all the calculation along with the problem in the next video. Okay. The first one is a closing stock reserve. And the next one, profit element of stock shortages. And the next one, value of loss in weight. These are the various items which is related to stock. And the next one, under credit side, opening stock reserve. Debit side, closing stock reserve. And credit side, opening stock reserve. And the next one, by loading on goods sent to branch. And the next one, profit element of stock surplus. And finally, you will be getting either gross profit or gross loss. Okay, both the items, either gross profit or gross loss, this will be transferred to profit and loss account. So this particular account I will explain along with the problem in the next video. Okay, now let us see the next one. The next one is branch profit and loss account. So here you are going to record all the items in order to find out the net profit or net loss. Okay, the first one is under debit side. The first one you have to record branch expense. Okay, this amount you can find out from the branch expense account. The next one, cost of goods lost due to shortage. So this you can find out from the other ledger. Separately we have prepared for stock. No, from that account you can find out this value. Okay. And the next one is the final answer will be either net profit or net loss. Now look at the credit side. You have to write first gross profit. This you can find out from the branch adjustment account. You have to enter any gross profit. Okay, that will be entered under credit side of profit and loss account. The next one, by cost of surplus if any. This you can find out from branch stock account. And a debit side you have to enter shortage. And a credit side you have to enter surplus. All these items you can find out from branch stock account. And the next one, by amount recovered from insurance company for any loss of stock. If you recover any amount from insurance company due to loss of stock, okay, that can be entered under credit side. Finally, you will be getting either net profit as a balancing figure or net loss. Whatever may be the result, that will be transferred to general profit and loss account. Okay, so this is called branch profit and loss account. So far we have discussed various accounts which comes under stock and debtor system. The first one, branch stock account. Next one, branch debtors account. Next one, branch expense account. The next one, branch adjustment account. And the next one, branch profit and loss account. Okay, with the help of this account, you can find out profit or loss at the branch. And the last one is goods sent to branch account. This account is prepared to find out the net value of goods sent to branch. Okay, so here you will find out the balancing figure. The balance of this account is either transferred to purchase account or trading account, depends on whether the firm is trading concern or manufacturing concern. So accordingly you can transfer either purchase account or trading account. Now let us see the problem for better understanding. See, under stock and debtor system, there are two types of problem. The first one is when goods are sent to branch at cost price. Okay. And the second one is when goods are sent to branch at invoice price. Invoice price means selling price. So these are the two cases which comes under stock and debtor system. So in this video, we are going to see the problem for the first one. That is when goods are sent to branch at cost price. In the next video, we will see the problem for when goods are sent to branch at invoice price. Now let us see the problem for the first one, that is at cost price. Look at the problem for when goods are sent to branch at cost price. Okay, see, the Chennai commercial company invoiced goods to its Madurai branch at cost. The head office paid all the branch expenses from its bank except petty cash expenses, which were paid by the branch. From the following details relating to the branch, prepare branch stock account, branch debtors account, branch expenses account and branch profit and loss account. Now see the information. The first one is opening stock 25,000, opening debtors 40,000, petty cash opening balance 500, goods sent from head office 80,000, goods returned to head office 4,000, cash sales 55,000, advertisement 3,000, cash received from debtors 85,000, closing stock 20,000, allowances to customers 500, discount to customers 3,000, bad debts 1,500, goods returned by customers to branch 2,000, salaries and wages 20,000, rent and rates 4,000, closing debtors 30,000, closing petty cash balance 300, credit sales 82,000. With this information, they ask you to prepare stock account, debtors account, expense account and profit and loss account. Now let us see the solution along with the format. First, we are going to prepare branch stock account. For that, look at the format. Look at the branch stock account format. Debit side, opening stock. Credit side, closing stock. Debit side, goods sent to branch. Credit side, goods returned to head office. And debit side, goods returned by debtors. Okay. And credit side, if there is any loss of goods, as well as you have to enter both the sales, both cash sales and credit sales. So these are the information you have to enter under branch stock account. That is inflow of stock and outflow of stock. Look at the problem. First, you have to prepare branch stock account. For that, just take all the informations which is relevant to stock. That is opening stock, closing stock, goods sent to branch and goods returned to head office, cash sales and credit sales. So these are the transactions related to stock. Now just see the information. The first one, opening stock. So this you can enter in the branch stock account. And then goods sent from head office. That is goods sent to branch and goods sent from head office. Both are same meaning. So this you can enter under debit side. First, you have to start with opening stock and then enter goods sent from head office and then goods returned to head office. This you can enter credit side of branch stock account. Okay, so credit side. So these are the items under debit side and this will be credit side because goods returned to head office, that is outflow of stock. And then cash sales, this is also credit side. And then closing stock, that is under credit side. And then goods returned by customer to branch. Okay, when the customer returned goods to branch, it's an inflow of stock. So this will be entered under debit side of branch stock account. And then credit sales, this is also outflow of stock. This will also enter under credit side of branch stock account. So these are the informations relevant to stock account. Now you can easily prepare branch stock account to find out surplus or shortage. Look at the solution. Now we are going to prepare branch stock account. Debit side, start with opening stock. So first item, to balance brought down. How much opening stock? Opening stock how much? 25,000. 25,000. See the problem. The next one, goods sent from head office, that is goods sent to branch. How much? 80,000. This is also under debit side. See, next item, to goods sent to branch. How much? 80,000. See the problem. First, we'll try to enter all the debit items. So we have entered opening stock and goods received from head office. And then, okay, goods returned by customer to branch. This is also inflow of stock. This you have to enter debit side. How much? 2,000. In branch stock account debit side, to goods returned by customer to branch. How much? 2,000. So these are the three items which is inflow of stock. Okay. All these need to be recorded under debit side of branch stock account. Now let us see the item under credit side. Look at the problem. So far we have entered items under debit side. Now let us see the items under credit side. The first one is goods returned to head office. That is, it is a outflow of goods. How much? 4000. See, under branch stock account credit side, the first one is buy goods returned to head office. How much? 4000. Look at the problem. The next transaction is cash sales. This is also outflow of stock. How much? 55,000. So credit side, buy cash sales, 55,000. Look at the problem. The next one is a closing stock. This you can enter at the last. Okay. And the next one, this you have entered. And the next one, credit sales. Okay. How much? 82,000. So enter under credit side. So credit side, buy credit sales. So even you can write this as a branch debtors account, because this you are going to record under debtors account. Okay. So how much? 82,000. See the problem. Last you can write closing stock. How much? 20,000. So under branch stock account, credit side, last item will be buy closing stock. So two balance carry down. So we have started with opening stock. That is two balance brought down, and you have to enter closing stock under credit side of branch stock account as buy balance carry down 20,000. Now you can close the account to find out either surplus or shortage. If you get any balancing figure under debit side, it will be treated as surplus. If you get any balancing figure under credit side, it will be treated as shortage. Okay, now get the total. Here 4000 plus 55,000 plus 82,000 plus 20,000. Total 1,61,000. Here 25,000 plus 80,000 plus 2000. So you are going to get the balancing figure under debit side. Now enter the value. First enter highest value. How much? 1,61,000. Okay, enter the same value here also. 1,61,000. So what is the balancing figure here? 54,000. So this is a surplus in stock. Okay, this is a balancing figure, and this will be transferred to branch profit and loss account. So this surplus you have to transfer to branch profit and loss account credit side. Okay, see the problem. First we have prepared branch stock account. So now we are going to prepare branch debtors account. So before we prepare this, let us see the format first. See the branch debtors account format. Debit side start with opening balance of debtors, and credit side you have to enter closing balance of debtors, if any. Okay. And again you have to enter debit side credit sales that already have entered under stock account. No. So you can refer branch stock account. Within the bracket you can mention credit sales. First you have to start with opening debtor balance and then add credit sales. Then you have to enter all the items under credit side. That is any cash received from debtors, any allowance to debtors, any discount to debtors, any irrecoverable amount, that is bad debts, any returns from debtors. All these items need to be entered under credit side, and finally you will be getting balancing figure as a closing debtor. Okay. Now see the problem. Look at the problem. Now we need to prepare branch debtors account. Now we have to take the transactions related to debtors. Okay, look at this. The first one is opening debtors. This you have to enter debit side of debtors account. Okay, and the next one, cash received from debtors. So this will be entered under credit side of debtors account. And the next one, allowance to customers. This is also credit item. The next one, discount to customers. This is also credit item. Then bad debt, that is irrecoverable amount from debtors. So enter under credit side. The next one, goods returned by customers to branch. So this is sales return. Okay, this will be entered under credit side. So already we have entered this item under branch stock account under debit side. The same will be entered even in the debtors account under credit side. Okay, how much? 2000. The next one, closing debtors. This will be entered under credit side. And the last one, credit sales. So this we have already entered under branch stock account. Again you have to enter this under debtors account under debit side. Okay, so these are the transactions related to debtors. Now you can easily prepare branch debtors account. See branch debtors account, first you have to enter opening debtor debit side and closing debtor credit side, and any credit sales, that will be entered under debit side, and all other informations like cash received from debtors, bad debts, discount allowed to debtors and allowances to debtors, all these items need to be entered under credit side of branch debtors account. Now start with opening balance, that is opening debtors. To balance brought down, okay, and closing balance if any enter credit side, by balance carry down. Okay, so if there is no closing balance in the problem means then the balancing figure will be closing balance, but in this problem both opening and closing balance is given in the problem. See the problem, opening debtors how much? 40,000 and closing debtors how much? 30,000. Debit side opening balance debtors how much? 40,000 and credit side closing balance, that is closing debtor balance, how much? 30,000. Then if there is any credit sales, that will be entered under debit side of debtors account. For that you have to mention branch stock account, because already we have entered in the stock account. So within the bracket you can mention credit sales. So to branch stock account. Okay, so within the bracket credit sales. Look at the problem. How much credit sales? 82,000. 82,000. We have started with opening debtors and we have added credit sales. Now total amount how much? 1,22,000 you have to receive from debtors. But we have closing debtor yet to receive how much? 30,000. Now you have to record how much cash you have received from debtors and what are the other expenses. Those items need to be entered under credit side. See the problem. Now how much cash you have received from debtors? See here, cash received from debtors 85,000. See, under debtors account, credit side, buy cash received from debtors. How much? 85,000. Okay. Now you have to enter all other expenses at branch related to debtors. Okay. Now see the problem. So this is the expense, that is allowances to customers 500. And then discount to customers 3,000. Bad debts 1,500. Okay, these are the expenses related to debtors that will be entered under credit side of debtors account as a branch expense. Look at the solution. Branch debtors account credit side by branch expense. So these are the expenses related to debtors. Allowance to customers how much? 500 plus discount to customer 3,000 plus bad debts 1,500. Total how much? 5,000. So this you are going to enter again under branch expenses account. But this expense purely related to debtors. That alone you have to enter under credit side of branch debtors account as by branch expense related to debtors. Look at the problem. We have started with opening debtors and we have added credit sales and we have entered how much cash we have received from debtors and we have entered all the expenses which is relevant to debtors account. Now we have to see if there is any returns from debtors that will be entered credit side of debtors account. Check any returns from debtors. Yes. Goods returned by customers. Customers means debtors. That is goods returned by customers to branch. How much? 2000. Enter this item under credit side. See the solution. So enter goods returned by customer under credit side of debtors account as by branch stock account. Why? Because this we have already entered under stock account. Within the bracket you can mention returns. So how much? 2000. Now you can get the total. Okay, but in this problem we have started with opening balance and we have entered closing balance. Okay, here there is no balancing figure. Why? Because both the sides we are getting equal balance. 40 plus 82, 1,22,000. 85 plus 5, 90. 90 plus 2, 92. 92 plus 30,000, 1,22,000. So there is no balancing figure. 1,22,000. 1,22,000. In most of the problem, the balancing figure will be either closing debtor or cash received from debtors. They will miss any one particular information. But according to our problem, they have given all the informations. That is opening debtor, closing debtors, credit sales and cash received from debtors and all other expenses related to debtors. Everything is given in the problem. So there is no balancing figure in this problem. Look at the problem. So far we have prepared branch stock account and branch debtors account. Now we have to prepare branch expense account. See the format for branch expense account. Okay, here you have to enter all the expenses related to branch under debit side of branch expense account. So generally, expenses can be classified into three categories. One is debtor related, another one is the branch expense which is directly paid by the head office, and certain expenses are called as petty expense. Okay, for that you have to see opening petty balance and closing petty cash balance. If there is any difference between opening petty cash and closing petty cash, the difference is called petty expense that you can enter under debit side. Okay, all the expenses need to be entered under debit side of branch expense account. Okay, now let us see the solution. Now we are going to prepare branch expenses account. I told you, there are three types of expenses. The first expense are any expenses related to debtors that you can find out from branch debtors account. And the next one is any expenses directly paid by the head office. So that will be given in the problem. So those expenses can be entered under debit side of branch expenses account. And the last one will be petty expense. Okay, out of petty cash. For that you can see the difference between opening petty cash balance and closing petty cash balance. If there is any difference, that expense called as petty expense. So all the expenses need to be entered under debit side. Okay, under branch expense account. For the first one, refer branch debtors account. Look at the branch debtors account. Already we have entered the expenses related to debtors as by branch expense. Now we have to enter the same value under debit side of branch expense account as branch debtors. So under debit side of branch expense account, first you have to enter to branch debtors account. So how much expenses related to debtors? 500 plus 3000 plus 1500. So all these expenses related to debtors. So total 5000. Now look at the problem for other branch expenses which is paid by head office. Look at the problem. Just find out any other expenses which is directly paid by the head office. Okay. See, advertisement. This is a expense, branch expense which is paid by the head office. This you have to enter debit side of branch expense account. And the next one, salaries and wages. Then rent and rates. That's all. So these are the branch expenses which is paid by head office. So how much advertisement? 3000 and then salaries and wages 20,000. So 3000 plus 20,000, 23,000 plus rent and rates 4000. So total 27,000 paid. So these are the branch expenses which is paid by head office. So under branch expense debit side to bank. So now you have to enter all the expenses, branch expenses. So how much advertisement? 3000 plus salaries and wages 20,000 plus rent and rates 4000. So total 27,000. Look at the problem. Here we have opening petty cash and closing petty cash. Okay, if there is any difference between opening petty cash and closing petty cash, that expense is called petty expense. Okay, that you can enter under debit side of branch expense account. How much opening petty cash balance? 500. Closing petty cash balance? 300. What is the difference? 200 difference. That is the petty expense which is directly paid by the branch. Debit side of branch expense account to petty expense. Okay, opening balance how much? 500. Closing 300. So 200 they have spent. So that is a petty expense. Okay, now we have entered all the expenses. The first expense related to debtors expense and the second one is branch expense and the next one is petty expense. Now find out the total. 5000 plus 27 plus 200. Total 32,200. Enter the same value under credit side also. 32,200. This is the total expense. This will be transferred to branch profit and loss account. Okay. So 32,200 by branch profit and loss account. This is the total branch expense need to be transferred to branch profit and loss account. This is the balancing figure. Okay, now we can prepare branch profit and loss account. Look at the problem. So far we have prepared stock account, debtors account, expenses account. Okay, now we have to prepare branch profit and loss account finally. Okay, for that look at the format. Look at the branch profit and loss account. First you have to enter all the expenses under debit side, expenses as well as loss under debit side, and all surplus gain under credit side in order to find out the net profit or net loss. So under debit side you have to enter branch expense. This you can find out from previous account, that is branch expense account. You can take the total expenses, branch expense, and if there is any loss due to shortage, okay, that can be entered under debit side. And credit side, first you have to enter gross profit, that you can take from the branch adjustment account. So this account we didn't prepare because this account is related to when goods sent to branch at selling price, that we will see in the next video. Okay, here we have got surplus in branch stock account, that you can enter as a first item. The first item will be surplus, that you can take from branch stock account. And if there is any amount recovered, any income received from the insurance company, that you can enter credit side. And finally you will be getting either net profit or net loss. Again I'll tell you, enter all expenses and losses under debit side and all surplus and gain and any amount recovered from insurance company under credit side in order to find out either profit or loss. Now you can prepare branch profit and loss account. So credit side, first you have to start with surplus, that you can find out from the branch stock account. Look at the stock account. Look at the branch stock account. We have got surplus, no? So this you have to transfer to branch profit and loss account. How much? 54,000. This will be the first item under credit side of profit and loss account. Under profit and loss account, credit side, by branch stock account. Okay, that is surplus. How much? 54,000. Okay, in this problem there is no amount recovered from insurance company. That's all. We have only one surplus that we have taken from the branch stock account. Now we have to enter all expenses and losses under debit side of branch profit and loss account. For that, see the previous account, that is branch expense account. So branch expenses account, we have got the total expense. How much? 32,200. This you need to transfer to branch profit and loss account. No, so enter this value under debit side of profit and loss account. Under branch profit and loss account, the first expense will be branch expense. Okay, how much? Total expense 32,200. See, here we have entered surplus and we have entered expense. Now the difference between total surplus minus expense is equal to net profit. So which one is highest value? 54 is the highest value, no? So enter 54 under credit side and enter the same value debit side also. So the final balancing figure will be the net profit. So 54,000 minus 32,200, 21,800. This is the net profit. This is the balancing figure. Okay, we have started with surplus 54,000 and we have subtracted total expense 32,200. The balancing figure 21,800 is the net profit. Okay, this is the way to find out net profit according to stock and debtor system. In this video, we have seen the problem for when goods are sent to branch at cost price. In the next video, we are going to see the problem for when goods are sent to branch at invoice price. Okay, you can find the link in the description box. Hope you like the video. Thank you.